I like touring. I like new places, and I like change, and I like, you know, getting to play my music for people every night. Every tour I go out on, I get a little more disconnected from home life. The more you transition to that, the more you become like, that becomes normal life, and home life is odd life. I feel more comfortable on the road. One of the hardest things for me coming home from tour is like allowing myself to stop. Because like you get in this, the wheels on the bus go round and round. And for me, like I don't know how to stop running. It's like I'm just like slowly cutting these bonds to some kind of normal life. Like I love my house, I love like being away from the city, you know, but then I also have to be like alone with my thoughts and like process all this shit.
Packing up your suitcase. So go on, wave goodbye, Mississippi mud, where I lost my
for the friends that I have here, because they all kind of get my life and get what it, that I'm gone for long periods of time. Then I come home and we get to be together and have dinners. And, outside of home is like, and it is very different. It's just what I do is what I do, and like, and it's more fun when we don't talk about it. You know, I think quality friendships aren't based in what people do, it's based in who people are.
Music for me has always been about community, and I mean, from the start, the get-go, when I was 17 picking up guitar, I was just chatting with friends and swapping songs, and I think that's part of the tradition of music, that it's just people sharing with other people. It's been a landmark year for him, and I think it's important for friends to rally around other friends when there's a big moment, and celebratory moment. And he's definitely one of those few people that I meet that is chasing and is hustling, but he's doing it because he wants to contribute something honest and good. I think we have the best job in the world, and I want us to continue to enjoy it, and I want Noah to be crazy successful, and I know that he will. Want that for him to create, because it's necessary and we need it. I need it. I need his music, and I know a lot of other people would agree.
Smoking ash like a memory. light me up again if it makes you feel free. Light me up again, call me a snake and a lion, and I will be the fire.
It's very easy to get wrapped up in what you make, and what you make is who you are, and who you are is what you make. It's fucking scary. So much of your self-worth is also based in this thing that you make, and your identity. Even if it's not the case for my relationships, it's the case for my relationship with myself. What if I wake up tomorrow and I'm paralyzed and can't do this? What value do I have? Or what if, I get, throat cancer or something and live but can't sing or can't make stuff, how do I come to terms with who I am outside of this thing that I make? Your value as a person is so tied up in your expression of your person in a thing that you sell. And I think so much of the artist life that we're told we're supposed to live is one where you're never satisfied. And that is what drives us, and that is what makes people, that's what makes the Beatles make Sgt. Pepper and the White Album, because they weren't satisfied with doing it this way. So you're taught to not be satisfied. Where does that end? And how do you balance that drive with gratitude? Because I think, gratitude is the great cementing factor.
When I was younger, I had a hunger down in my stomach. You couldn't touch it. I sang loud and I really meant it. Just hoping that people would notice a dumb kid with a bad haircut. More than anything, wants to be famous and have people listen to all of his songs. I've got no good sense for time. Every year passes quickly by. It's worth it when I'm gone. All my dreams I carry with me in a bag of broken glass. It's not the parts of busted hope, just the memories of. Make the good things last. I owe a lot to my little sister for sticking with me, though I've subjected her to so much bullshit. Nights all alone. While I'm out drinking with some new friends who soon become old friends, and I'll forget them and find some new ones to carry my load. I've got no good sense for time. Every year passes quickly by. I only hope it's worth it when I'm gone. Oh, my dreams I carry with me in a bag of broken glass. It's not the parts of busted hope, just the memories of the past. So make the good things last.
when I was a kid, it was this mentality of, I'm gonna do this no matter what. You know, if I have to work at a coffee shop for the rest of my life, it's fine as long as I get to play music. Now it's different when you have something to lose. Next tour, no one could show up. Or no one could buy the next record. Or, you know, when you haven't sold any records, it's a lot easier to fail because you have nothing to compare it to. But it's, yeah, this was the first tour where I started to struggle with that a little bit. And I had to, like, halfway through be like, all right, I can't look at numbers anymore. This isn't what it's about. I think it's important for me to stop and think that, like, I've reached the goal that I wanted. So now what do I do with that? And what are the new goals? And then, but what happens when I reach those new goals? I don't know.
I got a lot of loose ends. I've done some damage. I've cut the rope so it free. And I got a lot of good friends keeping me distracted, keeping my sanity safe. Here I stand on the edge of the ledges I've made, looking for a steady hand. Here I stand in the land of the rocks and the valleys, trying to be a better man.
Creating and sharing and putting your creation out into the world is truly like one of the most vulnerable and intimate things that anyone can do.
I drink a little too much.
I don't know how I would do it if I didn't have a connection with other people that did the same thing. Just people that are brave enough and courageous enough to take that step out and be vulnerable and be open. Know that after you bleed publicly and after you sweat publicly, that you can step back and have people that get it.
Here I stand on the edge of the ledges I've made, looking for a steady hand. Here I stand in the land of the rocks and the valleys, trying to be a better man for you.
I've had moments in my life, seasons where I'm writing every day and it's hard but it's also rewarding. It's also like, I think what I fear the most in that kind of routine is that I'm gonna sit down and have nothing to say. And that's really fucking scary. Because if nothing cool happens, what good am I?
Bear all the consequences.
But every day I have to face that fear. And I think that's a good, I think it's hard, but I think it's good.
Forgive me all that I've done. Here I stand on the edge of the ledges I've made, looking for a steady hand. Here I stand in the land of the rocks and the valleys, I'm trying to be a better man. Oh, here I stand on the edge of the ledges I've made, looking for a steady hand. Oh, here I stand in the land of the rocks and the valleys, trying to be a better man for you.
I'm trying to figure out how to be like an adult, be a businessman, and be a creative who's making something worthwhile. And do I choose to believe that like what I make matters? Does art matter? Yeah. I don't know.
Are you gonna call me? Are you gonna let it slide? I ain't looking for no sympathy. Just a reason to feel justified. That was unexpected. All the way you came on slow. We were both getting sober. When I told you I would take you home. Now the sun came up too soon today. You left to drive your band back to LA. And I'm not thinking you. I don't even want to. Honey, I'm not thinking of you anymore. I'm not thinking of you. Not the way you want me to. Honey, I'm not thinking of you anymore. I know you promised nothing. Oh, and nothing's all you should. All I wanted was some comfort. But you were running like a fugitive. Was it something special? Or just another way out? Like the credits to a movie. Or seeing Jesus in the temple. The sun came up too soon today. You left to drive your band back to LA. And I'm not thinking of you. I don't even want to. Honey, I'm not thinking of you. I'm not thinking of you. Not the way you want me to. Honey, I'm not thinking of you anymore. I'm the way out. We were naked.
You have to be willing to try to be real. Yeah. And I think if I can just do that, if I can embody creativity with my entire life, how I present myself, how I interact with people, how I run a business, then I just have, like, I just believe that in some way it makes the world a slightly better place.
You don't make me. Cool. I can carry on. The truth is that you do not the way.